problem is not with the burning question, but it's fair to say that I will never host this show ever again outside of the SDN studios because we are having incredible audio difficulties. And it's a great way to welcome our newest Burning Questions participant, who is going to be a regular, Bronte Nieuwenburg from Salky App. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you, Jason. How are you doing?
You're actually from Queensland. You're not from Salky App. That's not a country or an island, is it? You're a Queensland girl, but yeah. She works with Salky App. We'll talk about that later. Christopher Svanosio. It's not the way you've popped your collar for Burning Questions. You're really just letting everybody know what you're all about. You're in career best form and you're just saying, I'm going to pop the collar. I like it.
I haven't really had time to get changed from the trial, so and then I've got to go back to Kilmore shortly. So
I love harness racing participants, Andy, but they never miss an opportunity to tell you about how hard they work. You're not working today. What are you doing today, Mr. Denham College?
Yeah, no, I'm just sitting here waiting for burning questions for like a minute. Get going.
Thanks, heaps, mate. Appreciate it. Have you met Bronte Nieuwenburg before? Have you ever had an association with horses or not?
Who's answering this, me?
No. I'm asking Andy, but he doesn't want to hear me. Have you ever had an association with Bronte Nieuwenburg with horses, Andy? That can't have been. I don't think the horses went that well.
I don't think he was really happy about it.
Have you guys had arguments in more recent times?
Because
that was quite a dramatic exit, I've got to say.
We had lovely horses with Andy.
Christopher Svanosio, have you met Bronte?
No, I haven't. Not hoping to get to Queensland in a month's time or something, Jason.
Yeah, because I know you've been leaning on myself and Rob Orbiter to try and get the horses there. We're still working on it. It'll happen. Don't worry about it. It'll be fine. Andy Gath will be back with us in a moment. There's five burning questions, not four, so we can welcome Bronte in. And she's going to give us the details from a perspective of Salky App, as well as maybe her own opinions. Andy, welcome back. I'm going to give you a little tick. Andy, Bronte seems to think that there was no problem and you own some lovely horses together, but then she was left in two minds when you decided to disappear when I asked you about the association that you've had with the family. Is it okay?
Oh, no.
Andy, are you there?
I can't hear anything, sorry.
Hi, Andy. Can you hear me now? Well, we're going to have to start again.
I think Andy's the problem, though, because when he goes off,
everything's fine, isn't it?
Everything's fine. There's no feedback. It wasn't me.
Oh, my Lord.
Andy said he had no reception, so he drove up the road, and he's sitting up the road in the dark.
All right, we'll wait for him again. I've got to go to work soon, Snoozer. Media people work really hard as well.
What's on tonight?
Greyhounds on Ladbrokes.
Yep.
Maybe Andy has his like sound turned off.
Can you hear us now, Andrew?
Yeah, I can now. I could only hear every third word, if that.
Said. Glad you didn't say that on the actual recording. Yeah, we're about to start again. Right, 3, 2, 1. Hello, kidlings. Burning questions. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. We have a brand new special guest. She's here from Salky App. She comes from Queensland. She's dressed up beautifully for the occasion. I don't know what colour I'd call the top. I'm going to say fuchsia, but it's probably a long way off the mark. How are you, Bronte Nieuwenburg?
I'm doing very well. Thank you, Jason. How are you doing?
I'm good, but we have had some technical problems. We're not going to lie about that, and we know I'm not a technical genius. Have you met Andrew Gath before?
I believe I have met Andy when I was very young, but Andy's had a nice long association with my family and racing.
You might have been young. I don't reckon Andy was. How are you, Andrew? Are you good?
No, I'm fine. Thanks. Yeah, no, I was probably mid-30s when I met Bronte, so that was a while ago.
Yeah, it would have been like 1968. Incredible. Beatlemania was around. Snoozer, how are you, my friend? And have you met Bronte Nieuwenburg?
No, I'm going good. Thanks, Jason. I haven't met her yet, but hoping to meet her in Queensland in July.
Is there some sort of linear association with the fact that your stable's going so well at the same time that Sulky App was inaugurated? Are you using this for all your form now? Like, have you improved as a driver because you know the gates better, your horses properly? Well, I'm just trying to put my finger on it. I'm not saying you've gone bad, Snooze, but you seem to be going really well at the moment.
I'm not using it yet, but maybe I'll have to get into it and have a good look at it.
I think you might have to send him some merchandise there, Bronte, if you want to get him involved. He says he's not using it. I don't know if I 100% believe him. Five burning questions. We're going to start, and Bronte's going to bring us all the information from Sulky up with these races and these questions. We're going to start with, will fitness and his draw ensure that RC rolls Galeno guns, or can those mares be dangerous if fate affords them perfect runs? Now, you shocked the entire world, at least the Southern Hemisphere, when Aroa Kaui was going so well, and you said, he's a nice horse, but he's no RC Phoenix. Will you be winning Saturday night, Snoozer?
I intend to be working forward. Hopefully Bronte's got some good information for me there and I can get somewhere up the front. But, yeah, he should go very good. He's had a couple of runs and he's getting fitter every time. But there's a couple of very good mares that are going to be coming at me from behind if I've done too much work, probably.
You think you're a moral, actually, don't you, Snooze? I mean, I can read you like a book. You think you're an absolute morale, don't you?
No, I definitely don't. I think his couple of runs have been against pretty, like, a lot easier opposition. So this will be his first real big test this time back. And you know, I'm hoping he can run a great race.
Now you've disrespected your previous opposition. I don't know about that, Snoozer. Andy Gath, your thoughts. RC Phoenix, there's a bit of speed inside, but hangs, burns, finds the front and beats the two mares first up from a break or not?
I think he does. He's a quality horse. Got better each preparation. He's had an ideal preparation leading into this race. He's had two easy kills. Been over 1,700. He's no guarantee to find the lead, but he can be able to control the race from outside him. Anton's two fillies, or two mares now, quality mares, but generally Anton's horses take a couple of runs to hit top gear, so I think Snooze's horse will be far too.
Tell you what, Bronte's given us a couple of early hair flicks here. A little bit from Sol, yeah, but a couple of... difficult to concentrate. A rose between three thorns. Right, Bronte, what do the ratings say? Is RC Phoenix, I think I've marked him about $1.70. Is he rated well above Revelstoke and Ygret or not?
He is the best rated in the race, but Revelstoke's not that far behind. And when I do look at the gate speed for this particular race, Royal Charlotte does have the superior gate speed and Revelstoke follows through Royal Charlotte. So it's going to be difficult, I think, for RC Phoenix to get into a good spot fast.
I'd scratch now for you, Snooze. Take the opportunity and just scratch. The first of our sponsors, as it should be with Bronte Nieuwenburg joining us, is Sulky App, combining the power of results and horse sectionals, telling Chris Svanosio he can't win because he's got a wide draw. With Sulky App, you now have access to gate speed, swooper ability and behaviour ratings. Never miss a trainer, driver or gear change again. Sulky App is a form guide revolution. Sign up at sulky.app. Question number two. Can Stride attempt his last start trick and beat Elida twice? Or will this slightly fitter queen have eyes square on the prize? Better ask you first again, Snoozer. Aroa Kaui stepping up to the big time. What do you reckon?
Yeah, obviously, probably Ultimate Stride finds the front, so it's going to be tough for the rest of us. On his back, it'd be the place to be, but I think a couple of us will have that idea. But Queen Elida wasn't good enough to beat Ultimate Stride last time, and... yeah, it looks tough for her again, I thought, and like we're hoping Aroa Kaui can be, he's probably going to be back with Queen Elida and getting into it at some stage, but yeah, Chris Lang's horse looks very hard to beat.
Tell you what, just because it was his former boss and he's, I don't know, you don't need to suck up anymore, you've got your own life, you're living your own life. Queen Elida is an absolute moral. Surely Sulky App tells us that Queen Elida is a certainty here, Bronte, please.
You know, I have to agree with you, Jaybon. I think that Queen Alita can actually cross Ultimate Stride at the start. I'm not saying she'll get the front, but she is a length 0.1 faster than Ultimate Stride off the gate. So if Chris Alford, if he's driving her, I believe he has the intention to go forward, I think he could get in front of Ultimate Stride before he gets the chance to get to the front.
I wouldn't be shocked if he did it, but I'll tell you what.
Courage
Stride is likely, he's got a bit of early speed as well. Andy, I don't care where she settles. Chris Lang pulled off a master stroke, a little bit of a Penn and Teller, Chris Angel mind freak trick last time. But Queen Alida, she'll bounce back. I think she's immoral. Make it 3-1, please, Andy. Don't make it 2-2 with Snoozer.
No, it'll be 2-2. I'm with Snoozer. I don't know why you think she'd be any fitter. She's been racing every fortnight, so shouldn't be any different to last time. I think Ultimate Stride will find the top and run along again and be a solid mile rate, and he's got every chance of being too good again.
This is a secret. I don't think I'm supposed to say this, but Chris Alford told me she put a lot of condition on, even though it was only a couple of weeks between runs. She was fat. She puts on a lot of weight, you understand? And I think she'll be a little bit fitter. And I'll tell you what, I reckon if he hadn't dropped in last time, the puppet, she would have won anyway, shouldn't we? Bronte and I are right, Snooze and Andy wrong, but it's great to have this debate, even if somebody has to be right and somebody has to be wrong. Pride's Easy Feed is another sponsor of Burning Questions. They're a proud supporter of the harness racing industry with their set recipes and quality ingredients to give the trainer confidence in what they're feeding. So make the switch to Pride's and start getting the result you've been chasing. Nothing about Team Ashworth this week. Oh, that's fun by three. Question number three. What will Little Hurricane produce in Fast Class Fresh, and just how well will Isolate perform against the best? Now, I thought Tango Tara, even though he's a bit of a funny horse, might kick up and hold the front here in the Lazarus free-for-all, Andy Gath, as you move into the darkness. You're like Bane, I'm into the darkness. What are your thoughts? Is Tango Tara going to kick up here?
Yeah, obviously, doesn't draw barrier one very often. He's got pretty good gate speed. He can hold turret sane every time it's drawn outside. So I don't think any horse can cross him. And being over the short to over to 1700, yeah, it will be pretty keen to hold the front and try and lead throughout.
Can you lead throughout?
Just depends on the first quarter. Hurricane Harley gets out okay. I don't think it's going to force the issue too hard. So, yeah, he's going to have to sit off defence with pace.
Is Yen Bucky in any hope at all of causing a blowout? I'm going to say no to help you out, but if you've got a different opinion, please present it.
I'd probably say no. From that draw, a bit of speed inside him, he'd probably just go back and just try and come with one run, which is not really his go. So, yeah, he's going to be up against it.
Bronte, Selkiap has been a wonderful revolution, you and the old man, Jerome, who has a good association with Andy as well. Gate speed here is very tricky to work out mathematically because they've nearly all got good gate speed. Can Andy actually hold the front here with Tango Tara? Who's going to win? Who tops the ratings, and can Tango Tara lead all the way, according to Selkiap?
So Torrid Saint's gate speed is 0.9 lengths better than Tango Tara, but because he's drawn right outside him, he needs to be probably 1.2 lengths better to actually get in front of Tango Tara. So you'll probably find if Torrid Saint might have a crack, it will probably only get half a link in front. And then Max Delight has more gate speed again than Tango Tara, but not as much as Torrid Saint. So I can see Tango Tara kicking through. I can't see him winning. But I can see Hurricane Harley still winning.
Max Delight used to have gates, but I think he lost it in a bunker somewhere. Absolutely declared him a couple of weeks back. I still haven't quite gotten over it. Snoozy, your opinion on the Lazarus free-for-all, which amazingly, for a horse who wasn't much good over a mile, is over 1,720 metres. God bless everybody who comes up with these race names and puts them in certain races. What do you think is going to happen in the free-for-all?
Well, I think Lazarus did run the second fastest mile of all time at the Red Mile a few years back, so he went all right over the mile, but probably Hurricane Harley.
Svanosio with us. He's been a wonderful guest. Appreciate your time, mate. No, all right. Your thoughts on the race, mate?
Yeah, like I think Mark Pitt's probably going to have a crack at getting across Tango Tara, and that'll be, if Hurricane Harley finds a front, well, it looks sort of his race to lose from there, but like Andy's horses a fair chance of kicking through and making him work, and that'll completely change it. That'd sort of really bring better isolate into it. But yeah, I thought if Harley can probably lead and win, look at it.
Andy, will better isolate measure up or not?
I think you need a couple of cracks at this level. And I think from the draw, I don't think Matty will use him early, so it has to be tempo related. But I think in time it will.
I've got a funny feeling this might be your best bet because I've been told. Was Terra's trial, that is Magnetic Terra, was Terra's trial a telling sign he's set to bring the pain, or is the best of Bollinger just on a different plane? Based on the trial, I can't see how. Well, the only little question mark is whether Magnetic Terra can get across, but the opinion you have of this horse, I'm not sure you care that much.
No, he's a quality horse. He won well first up and then disappointed second up, and he put up quite quick after that run. That's why we haven't seen him for so long. Took him a while to get over that. So, yeah, pretty pleased with his trial. It'd be better for that hit out, and Relentless Me can sort of hold him if it wants to, but I think with Bollinger on its back, it might relent to us, and I think if we find the top, it should be too good, Magnetic Terror.
So you're saying Relentless Me will relent to you?
I reckon it will.
I don't think he got the gag there, unbelievably. You know why? Because you can't see. You're actually all in darkness. Bronte's the only one who's in the light. She's going to heaven. You're both going to hell. Snoozer, some thoughts here? Magnetic Terror, the one to beat?
Yeah, he looked really good in his trial. And obviously, Bollinger's had plenty of trialing for Dean Braun. He's been a good horse in New Zealand. But, yeah, it's hard to see from his trials here that he's like Andy's horse definitely looked a bit better than him last week. So Bollinger's going to be in a bit of traffic and it'll be very tough for him.
Bronte, I'll tell you what's annoying for Sulky out. And Andy Gath, people like Andy Gath bring these horses over from New Zealand because you can't get the same data that you want, that precious data. But you have got data on one runner who at one point I declared as being one of the next big things. Let me tell you, he hasn't been one of the next big things yet. But Knights Templar, it's a nice little trailing draw off the second row and has been trialing well also. He's very highly rated in your ratings at Sulky App, isn't he? And he's got a gear change too.
Yeah, he hasn't raced for a long time, but it's one of the even races of the night. I would say that Knights Templar, Sly Terror and Magnetic Terror and a few other runners all have a very similar rating. But yeah, Knights Templar seems to just be a little bit better rated than the rest, ever so slightly. And in saying that, we do have limited data on Magnetic Terror, obviously. So it's tricky. And I do like Relentless Me as well. It has a very good rating.
As long as it doesn't relent, Relentless Me. Tell me this, if you're working them at home and you put them to the sword, how much difference is there between Magnetic Terror and Sly Terror? I'm going to guess 18 metres. Andy.
Yeah, that's probably about right. Yeah. You know, one's a really nice horse in Sly Terror, but I think one's going to end up being a free-for-all horse.
Let's hope so, because you've been pumping him up. Final of our sponsors that we're going to touch on, and Bronte, by the way, you're going to have to scale the data for a best bet at the end of this from Sulky App as well. Falvo Fruits, they grow top-quality table grapes, not your average run-of-the-mill low-quality table grapes. I hate those. The top-quality table grapes. They're on the farms of Weeman and Liparoo. Never been to either of those places. And working very closely together with the premier farms in Australia. These table grapes are delivered to customers all over the world. Remember, everyone eating grapes is good for you. Now, Bronte, we ask all of our new guests this very important question. What is your favourite fruit?
My favourite fruit?
Yes.
Oh,
are you an apple girl? Do you like orange? Are you a pear girl? Are you a grape lady? Do you like a peach? Are you a stone fruit woman?
Wow. I have an acai smoothie every morning, so banana and acai berries.
Acai berries? Yeah, I think there's some of those in the freezer. I've never, I don't know what they are, so I wouldn't touch them. Snoozer, have we ever found out your favourite fruit?
Yeah, I have bananas every day.
He's actually holding himself back from having a banana now, I reckon, Andy, to be honest. Last question of the burning questions. Five, one extra for our new guest, Bronte Nieuwenburg. Will ants plant the grace this weekend with the Gifted Black, and does that make the race for what? Who's sitting on her back? That Melton Mares Championship, Andy, is confusing to me. Have you worked it out? Bronte's left, but I'm about to let her back in. Have you worked it out, Andrew?
No, it's a little bit tricky. I think Ange will be holding the lead on a horse which is an antipode of you. So with it in front, I think it'll be, with Major Grace sort of posted, I think it'll be, probably brings Snooze's horse into the race and so what. But it's been pretty impressive, Major Grace, since been over here. It's definitely the one to beat, even if it's stuck outside him.
Where are you going after this, Andy, by the way?
I'm going to dinner out with my sister-in-law, whose birthday today. But I'm going to be late because of you.
Just calm down. Courtney Thompson and I have already had our blues in the past. She'll be fine. You can blame me. Everyone blames me for everything anyway, Andy, even though it is actually my fault on this occasion. But I'll tell you what, we did work out that I reckon you were the problem with the audio. I don't want to play the blame game, but as soon as you disappeared, everything seemed to go a little bit better, I've got to say. Happy birthday, Courts. I'm going to guess 34 years of age. I hope I haven't gone 1 year over. Snoozer. Is it 34? Snoozer. Heavenly Charm, what do you do at the start?
Well, I probably haven't got enough gate speed with a couple of real quick ones around me. So I'll be just trying to get as good a spot as I can. But, yeah, it looks like if Ants does hold the lead, it really probably makes it for so what if it can be leaders back. But obviously the couple of better mares are possibly going to be in his horse will be in the breeze and the Rickson's horse. So it's a pretty hot mares race sort of.
Do you think Ants will hold the front, Snoozer?
He does like to hold the front, and I think he'd probably be in front.
Bronte, very confusing race, I'd say, for Solgap as well. There's plenty of gate. It's not. Bronte basically just gave a shake of the head, like, not a confusing race. I've got the winner for you. If you'd like me to tell you, shut up, Jay Bond, and I'll just tell you. All right, Bronte, take it away.
Well, so what? Just rate better than the rest. So. Young Gifted and Black doesn't. If Anthony does hold the front, I just can't see So What getting beat. And Prezi Bell rates very well as well, but it's got a bad draw.
This is lovely. We've got the first little sign of swaggery arrogance from Bronte Nieuwenburg based on the Sulkyev. I just think it's. I don't even know why they're running the race. I'd call it off
it's
right
just
now.
That the one horse has the best gate speed and the one behind it is the best rated.
He's on bloody pleased, I tip. So what on top at the moment? Would have been quite embarrassing. I'd be red-faced if I didn't. Time for our best bets. Andy Gath, I already think I know who yours is, and it was nearly going to be mine, but we've got a new tab special, I reckon, coming up with our best bets that they're going to combine. So I couldn't take yours. Who is it? Are the initials MT?
Sly Terror. No, Magnetic Terror. I think you'll be able to get the job done.
Where's Kate right now? Are you going together or is she already at court?
She's probably waiting impatiently for me to come back and get ready because she's is scared of her little sister.
Well, she won't know you're doing burning questions because she doesn't watch. So just just say you're watching Kiwi replays in the car like you normally do. Snooze, your best bet, please.
Does it have to be one of mine?
No, you can go anywhere you like. Feel free. Liberate yourself. Have you got another one?
No, I thought Sweet Passion would probably win the first for Declan Murphy. Was real good last week coming from back in the field, and it's drawn a lot better this week. So thought it'd be very hard to beat in race one.
As long as it doesn't wait for him. As long as it doesn't wait for him, Snoozer. I feel like it's waiting for him a bit sometimes. Bronte Nieuwenburg from Sulkia, from Queensland, in a beautiful top with the hair swinging around early in the show, in a lovely room with some knickknacks in the background and a guitar that I wonder whether she can play. Do you play the axe, by the way, Bronte?
Do I play the guitar?
Yeah.
Not electric, but I do play acoustic.
I'll teach you to play electric. That'll be part of your payment for coming on Burning Questions. tell us, what does Selkap say is the best of the night? I'll tell you what, if it's not So What, how swaggery you were about So What, then the other one's an absolute certainty. Who is the best?
I didn't intentionally have a little bit of swagger then. I was just trying to, I just didn't see it as being complicated in a small field. But I do like So What. That was my best bet, but I also like Lip Reader a play. So if you could put them in a multi.
There you go. I'll tell you what, Sulky App, right on the button, because Lip Reader, only got a run, I think, this morning. I'm going to go with Queen Elida. It's a cheap kill for me. I need a best bet to win because right now I could stop a freight train. I could stop a freight train, and I just need something. $1.60 is good enough for me, even though a couple of our panellists are trying to think is. Bronte Nieuwenburg's with me, and that means I have the power. Bronte, have you enjoyed your first burning questions?
Yeah, it's been super fun. Thanks, Jason.
Can you give us one more hair flick?
Oh, that wasn't it. I was fixing my headphones too, but there you go.
Snoozer, thanks very much for joining us, mate. We couldn't get you last week, but we got you this week. Good luck with everything. You're in career best form because you're following Sulky up, even though you don't admit it. Good luck on Saturday night.
Thanks, Bonners.
And Andy?
Yes.
I don't know whether you're dead or you're in a crypt or you're in a tomb or you're a vampire. It's been wonderful. If I'd ever see you again, because I can barely see you now, it's been great knowing you, and it's great to have you back on the show, and hopefully Courtney Thompson doesn't rip you a new one when she turns up. Was I right with 34, by the way?
I have no idea. I would have gone with 29 just to be safe.
I think the fact that you've said you have no idea has probably put you in more excrement than anything else, even if I'm wrong, and I've gone 1 year too high. Well done to everyone involved, Bronte Nieuwenburg from Sulky App, Chris Svanosio from Fatherhood, and Andy Gath from The Crypt. That's been Burning Questions. Hopefully everyone enjoys, and we found just a minute for the week.